about the size of like 6 inches by 6 inches. And then just crumple it up in a little ball. And that's what you're gonna use to put underneath your rocks because it will mold right to the rock and to the floor. Okay, to start off with, we're gonna pour some paint inside here. And so I'm just gonna do a combination of white, and then I'll just go ahead and let's put some red in there. As you can see, I'm kind of holding it high up so that it can just be a little bit more sporadic how it goes in. I don't want it to just be a big lump of paint. So I'm kind of just holding it up high just so that it's kind of trickling into the cup. Here's some yellow. And what we're gonna do is repeat everything that I put in here. Here's some pink. And now that I'm all done, I'm gonna start back over with the white. And some blue. Red, and so on and so on. I'm just going to do it twice, and then I will show you how I paint over it. Okay, so now here are all the colors that I poured into the cup, and so what I'm going to do is I'm just going to pour right over the top of a rock. Just let it spill over. And while that's kind of falling down, I'm gonna go ahead and do a couple more. It just wants to fall off to the sides, and I'll show you how we fix those blank spots in a second. And we'll go ahead and do another one. See how it's falling on the paper plate that I have it sitting on? Well, I'm gonna use those leftovers to scoop up and put in some of the blank spots. But before we do that, I want to give these a little spritz, which gives them those really pretty cells. So I'm just gonna take my spray. It's full of paint. Shake it a little and then just kind of lightly spritz over the top. And look what happens. We get those really neat cells and it immediately happens. So after that part is done, you're just gonna scoop up what's here at the bottom and hit some of the white parts that didn't get paint, like over here off to the side that didn't get any paint. So I might just dip that right inside the cup, dip my spoon into the cup, grab some paint on the spoon, and then just pour it over. And then that will fix those empty spots that are still need to have some coverage. So So that's really it. We're gonna let these dry for about 48 hours and then I will show you what you have to do to make them shiny and glossy. Okay, so here are a few that I just poured, so you can see just how beautiful all the variations of those same colors, and they always come out different. So a couple of coats will give it that glassy, very shiny, and just finished look. So this is my second coat, and try not to overwork the triple thick. Just put it on and brush it a few times and call it done. And then let it dry, and it will have this gorgeous, beautiful, glossy look.